Oh, let me get myself a little. I don't want to have bad breath. Honey, you don't have to. We're sitting so close to each other. I don't want to offend. All right.
Saucy.
Okay. Okay. Hey fellow beauty finders, it's Mathias Allen again with another Monday Makeup Chat, and today I have a really great guest star. Her name is Bianca. Hi Bianca.
Hi Mathias.
I'm so glad that you're here. I recently met Bianca. I got to know her quite well. She's extremely talented as a makeup and hair artist. There are some things that she's going to be helping teach you guys today, and myself. I hope you don't mind. I might be taking some notes. Bianca's working on her MBA.
Yes.
And she has also been a brand marketing manager for a few different companies, and she has a lot of experience about building your brand, also being a makeup artist and being a licensed cosmetologist. You know, she knows firsthand what it takes to kind of like get new clients.
Right.
So if you're a pro makeup artist and you're interested in this kind of information, then this is the Monday Makeup Chat for you. Okay, so in part one today, we're going to be talking about some of the key things that you need to be thinking about as a pro makeup artist or hairstylist. And Bianca, I want you to explain a little bit more about that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so tell me your thoughts.
Okay, yeah. So today, what I thought would be really interesting, like super fun, was just to talk about just the business behind like doing either makeup or hair, whether you're even a fashion stylist. There's also a big business component, and that includes marketing. So what I wanted to kind of touch on was just some branding, like kind of tips for you guys, and just to kind of give you a little bit of insight on how, if you're already building a brand or if you're starting from scratch, just some tips on what you can do to try to like really build your scope of influence.
And I know firsthand as a pro makeup artist for 20 years here in LA that like building your marketing business plan is very, very, very important. Mm-hmm. So I want to know, what's your first thing you want to talk about?
Absolutely. So first, what I wanted to kind of touch on was just kind of building your brand. I know that there are a lot of artists out there, and you've kind of like either hit a plateau, or like I said, you know, you're kind of just starting out. You don't have that issue.
Right. Oh,
but, you know, just you always want to kind of go bigger and better. So the first thing I want to really talk about was just kind of building your brand, meaning you have to have a visual identity. What that means is, who are you? You know, really look at who you are as a brand, what you want to convey. When people kind of look up like Mathias, what do they see? What do they see? Is it the same consistent message across like all of the social media brands? Like, what exactly do they see?
I think that's a really good point, because there are viewers out there who are makeup artists who are thinking about doing makeup artistry, and they're hearing you say that, and I really think they're thinking, tell me if this is true or not, but you're thinking, well, I'm a makeup artist. I don't have a brand. Like, I don't understand why. What are you trying to tell me?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Like, they really need to know that you, as your business of makeup artistry, whether it's bridal or celebrity or editorial or just working at the mall, like that is your brand.
That's your brand.
Right?
So there's two different kind of components to that. The first one is just the basics of marketing. Whether you have like business cards, or whether you have comp cards, whether you have a website. The branding part of that is looking at, what is your font like? What is your name gonna look like? What is your name? You know, what's your name on social media? Is it something that's easily referenced, or is it, you know, such and such and such and such at holler at me, da 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 da? You know, is it something that is easily like found as well? So from looking at the fonts that are on there, the color, what's your color aesthetic? When you think of yourself, are you, you know, a silver and black person? Do you want to have that across all of your social medias? How exactly are you going to brand yourself as your business? So that's really what, you know, is important about having a visual identity about your business first.
I think that's an interesting point that you bring up, and what it makes me think about for the person at home who's like, wait, this is so much to think about, and this is like, wow, huh? I think you need to think about it like you're opening a store, and the store is your makeup artist store where you're gonna take clients. What color do you want the walls to be?
Absolutely.
What color do you want the chairs to be? What color do you want your, you know, title, your storefront name
your
to be,
yep.
your banner? Like, right?
Absolutely.
So kind of think about it like that. Think about your career as almost like your own little boutique,
That's
your own little store, and kind of like design it in that way, that mm-hmm. aesthetic, right?
Right, because now your actual boutique or your store is online. So what you would kind of put, like, let's say on the walls, you know, are you a pink person? Like, what are you? Are you a flowery person? Is that going to like translate over into your website? Your car is gonna have like those same colors as well.
Right.
Whatever it is, it should be cohesive, and it should have a cohesive feel across all of your different brands.
Okay, so I think you brought up a really good point, because we were talking about, you know, building your storefront and kind of mm-hmm. like being your own designer and thinking about your colors. But I know a lot of people out there are gonna ask me in the comments, like, do I need a website?
Right.
What are your thoughts?
I think that that's a really good question. I'm sure that a lot of people think that. My perspective is, once you start to kind of take yourself seriously, people will also take you seriously as well. How do people differentiate you from the person that kind of does it as a hobby? It's something that you can love, but again, if you take yourself seriously and you brand it as, this is my business now, mm-hmm. you have to have those basic tools, like a website, like business cards as well, like mm-hmm. a business Facebook page or Instagram. You can use different things like Snapchat, but I think a website is like where people, even if there's nothing on it with just your name, your email address, and how to contact you, maybe a couple of photos, mm-hmm. I think it's really important, again, that people have somewhere where they can get in contact with you that looks official.
And for those of you out there wondering, okay, so you've suggested that I build a website. So mm-hmm. Once I have this website, like, how do I get people to actually like look at my website, or how do I promote my website?
Right.
You have to subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I'm gonna be asking Bianca that specific question coming up in part two of this multi-part series about building your brand as a pro makeup artist or a hairstylist. Mm-hmm. And we're gonna be talking about how you're gonna be cross-promoting your website mm-hmm. onto your social media platforms, and what social media platforms you really need to focus on
right.
this year.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sounds good.
So make sure you guys subscribe.
Yes.
Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Bianca, for being my guest today.
Of course.
I'm going to put Bianca's social media information down in my description, so make sure you go check her out, give her some love. And hopefully she'll be starting her own YouTube channel very soon, because I'm going to inspire her, because she's been inspiring me.
Aww.
So that will be happening this year.
Thank you.
Thanks, you guys, for watching, and I will catch you next time. Make sure to leave a comment if you have any more questions. Okay.
Yeah.
Bye. Hey, fellow beauty finders, it's Mathias Allen, otherwise known as Mathias for Makeup, and I'm so excited you died. I already fucked it up.
Okay.